Hi everybody, I'm Mike McCrory and this is Would You Make It? I know that most table saw motors can be converted from 120 volts to 240 volts, and that has a few advantages. As many of you have probably experienced at least once in the past, you may have tripped a circuit breaker or blown a fuse when cutting into something that's heavy or if the wood binds into the table saw blade. So I want to avoid that, especially because my table saw is plugged into the same circuit as the overhead lights. So when I blow a fuse, the lights go out, the garage doors are closed. That's kind of scary. To convert a motor, it's relatively simple. I've already got the garage wired for 240 volts because of my bandsaw. So all I need is a plug and some wire. So let's get started. Doing any rewiring, let's just run a little test. I'm going to mark a line on this shim, and I've got it wedged in the table saw blade. I'm going to turn it on. You can see that it wouldn't start. So also the lights dimmed. I don't know if you can see that or not. So hopefully by upgrading to 240 volts, I'll have more power at startup. The blade will start spinning faster. Even though I won't have more power overall at startup, I can have some advantage. So let's go around the back, open up the little wiring compartment on the motor, and we'll get out the manual and follow the instructions. So before you get started, you'll have to make sure that you have all the right tools and pieces that you need. The most important thing to consider is the 240 volt plug. There's different types of these, and they're designed for different amperages. So the one that I have is a 20 amp twist-on plug. They have some that just have straight plugs, you just push them in. They have 30 amp plugs, and they're not interchangeable. So what's really important is you start with your outlet, if you already have one. Make sure that the plug you purchase is gonna fit into that outlet. A 30 amp plug will not fit into a 20 amp outlet, and vice versa. So I've got these matched up. This is a 20 amp plug, 250 volt. That's the other thing to be careful of when you're buying these in the store. These are right next to the 20 amp twist on 120 volt or 125 volt plugs. They're not the same. They have different twist on connectors. So you want 20 amp, 250 volt or 30 amp, 250 volt, depending on what type of plug you have. All right, so the other things I have are my manual with the instructions. Here's the 120 volt circuit and the 240 volt circuit. I've got my wire that I'll use to make my new cable to go from the saw to the outlet. Got a box of Morettes. I'm not sure that I need these. These are Morette connectors or wire nuts. I'm not sure that I need these, but I have them here handy just in case. I've got some black electrical tape that I'll need and a screwdriver to open up the compartment. So here's my motor at the back. And I'm just going to unscrew this screw right here. One thing to keep in mind, and this is really important, what I'm about to show you is only for this table saw, this model of table saw. This is a rigid TS3650 that I have. The instructions for your motor may be somewhat different. It's doable, but different. So be absolutely sure that you follow the instructions in your manual. All right, so let's start by opening this electrical compartment. Gonna make sure the table saw is unplugged, which it wasn't. Now it is, so we're safe. Unscrew this. Open it up. And surprisingly, because this is an enclosed compartment, surprisingly it's full of dust. So the first thing I'll do is I'll clean this out with my air compressor. Okay, just a couple of quick blows. So we've got
four different connections, but a whole bunch of different colors of wires here. So it's pretty simple to just follow the instructions. So right now, because I'm on 120 volt, I've got white, and black connected. When I move that to 240 volts, I want to have just white and white connected, and I want to move the black one over to the orange wire. So let's take off the tape. I've got white and white. So right now it's white, and black. That needs to change to be just white and white. So I'm going to remove the black one and reconnect the white and white. Now the black one has to be connected to the yellow wire. The yellow is currently connected to the brown. The brown is going to be end up being just terminated and not connected to anything. So black and yellow. And connect that up. And red and orange are going to stay the same. So those two will stay the same as well. So I will need one additional Moret connector. I mean, it's not absolutely necessary, but I think it's safe to just put a connector on the end of the brown wire. And now I will tape them all up. Everything's taped up, it's clean. Let's go ahead and close the compartment up. Put the screw back in. All right. Now we're halfway there. The next step is to come around to the front of the table saw where we have the switch, and that's where the cord that plugs into the wall is connected. So I need to remove this plug and wire in the new wire that I have, the new cable, put a plug on the end of it, and then we're gonna plug it into the wall and test it out. Okay, so I've taken the switch off the fence guide, and that'll make it easier to work on. I'm just gonna open it up with the screw here. Here's the wire that comes in. It's got two wires, black, white, and green for ground. Because I don't have any of these types of connectors, what I'll do, actually I'll check my toolbox and see if I do, but if I don't, what I'll do is I'll snip the wires here, and then I'll use the Moret connectors to twist on the new cable. That should be fine. So I checked my toolbox, and I do in fact have some of these connectors, but they're only sized for up to 14 gauge wire, and I've purchased 12 gauge wire for this cord. So I won't be able to use these. It's not worth going to the store just for that. So I'm going to proceed with the Moret method that I talked about, connecting the two wires together, the existing wire that was already there with the connector to the new cable with the Morets. Well, this little plastic compression fitting was not that easy to get back in because of the fact that I'm using 12 gauge wire, but with the assistance of my water pump wrench to compress it and squeeze it through, I was able to get it in successfully. So now I'll strip the wire, do the connections, and we'll plug it in. So the switch is reconnected and reinstalled on the fence track. So now we're gonna connect the plug to the other end. Just a little piece of advice based on me making the same mistake many, many times over the years. Make sure you put the back piece, the cover, for the switch onto the wire first. Otherwise, it's hard to get it on after you've connected it. Don't forget to put this piece on too. Okay, it's all ready to go. I'm gonna go plug it in. First, we'll give it a test run just to see if it works. came on fine, and the overhead lights didn't dim for the first time ever. So let's put this piece in and give it a try. You can see the difference. So that piece was wedged in exactly the same as before. And even though I don't have any more overall power while the motor's running, it definitely starts up a lot faster and a lot more powerful. So that's going to be a real benefit. Now, I've read on the internet that anybody that's gone to 240 never wants to go back. So I'm really happy I've done this. I've used 240 volt saws before, but I've never converted one. So pretty easy. Would you do it?